Hey there,
I'm Mark Romero Jr., and today I'm going to give my real thoughts on the Bugs Bunny cartoon, Hair-Raising Hare, featuring the first appearance of Gosshammer, the big red monster, because of this one he's not referred to by a name. And then a second appearance, whatever Hare, he's called Rudolph. It would not be until the 1980s sort, Dick Dodd's in Return of 24.5 Century, they renamed Gosshammer. This one has Bugs Bunny following a girl robot rabbit, and Bugs doesn't even realize it's a robot at first, and there's a scientist based on Pierre Lorre who supposed to get him to see the monster. In fact, after the beginning, after Bugs runs into the monster, we don't really see the scientist again. We see Bugs Bunny running from the monster, and lots of great gags. One of my favorite gags comes when Bugs Bunny's like, is there a doctor in the house? And I remember the shadow member line shows up and says, I'm a doctor. That's really funny. It's like a memorable dream. And so Bugs doing the funerals and things, kind of memorable. This is the scene near the end where Gosshammer gets scared when he sees all the people. That is a good design for the female rabbit robot. Yeah. Everything is a good one. Well, Chuck Jones' early best. Yeah, like at this point, Chuck Jones is starting to get really, really better than he'd been for a long time. After doing a lot of Disney-esque stuff and a lot more cutesy stuff, he was starting to find his talents around this point. Those are my real thoughts on Hare-Raising Hare.